Good morning, children. Let us start with a new lesson today. It is Miss Rotimia has a hard day. Miss Rotimia has a hard day. We'll see what is in this lesson. Heidi woke up early the next morning. Puzzled, she lay trying to think how she came to be in this huge white bed. All at once, Heidi remembered that she was in a big city. She must see the blue sky and feel fresh spring air against her face. The thick curtains drawn across the windows shut those away. At that moment, there came a knock at the door. "Breakfast is ready," announced the maid. Heidi dressed quickly and went to the dining room. There Clara greeted her with a friendly smile. After breakfast, Miss Rotimia told Heidi to go to the library with Clara and wait for the tutor. When the tutor arrived, the two girls started studying. Miss Rotimia soon heard a violent crash followed by shouts. She rushed to the library, then stood horrified. The table was overturned in the middle of the floor. A stream of ink trickled slowly across the room. Heidi was nowhere to be seen. "What has happened?" cried Mr. Rotimia. "Everything is covered with ink. It must be Heidi." The tutor was gazing helplessly at the ruins. Clara, who was secretly enjoying herself, said, "Yes, it was Heidi. But she did not mean to. She must not be punished. She was in such a hurry to look into the street that she caught the tablecloth and pulled everything down." So this is about a girl called Heidi. So Heidi was somewhere in a village and she was brought to the city by this people, by the owner of this house, that is Clara's parents. Okay. So what? This is Clara. This is Clara, this girl, and she is Miss Rotimia. And he is the tutor. Tutor means teacher. Understood? This is Clara, Miss Rotimia, and the tutor. So this is about a Heidi called, it's a girl, her friend, Clara's friend. So she had come to city. She was staying in Heidi's house. Sorry, Clara's house. Just the previous day she has come to Clara's house. For learning purpose. It was for learning purpose. Understood? So what happened? See, Heidi woke up early the next morning. So the previous day she had come to Clara's house. Next morning when the sun rises, everybody wakes up from a bed, isn't it? Like that what happened? Heidi also woke up from a bed. Puzzled. She was puzzled. She was surprised. "Where am I?" Suddenly, no, because she had come only the previous day. All those days she was in her house. Now she has come to Clara's house. Suddenly when she woke up, she was puzzled. Puzzled, she was a little surprised. She was in a dilemma. "Where am I?" She was just thinking, "Where am I?" Puzzled, she lay trying to think how she came to be in this huge white bed. So she was having a very big bed, white color bed, because she was not using that bed in her house. Now in Clara's house, they have given a nice bed for her, big bed covered with white cover. Understood? So she was just puzzled. She lay trying to think how she came to be in this huge white bed. All at once, Heidi remembered that she was in a big city. So all of a sudden she remembered, "Oh yes, I am not in my house. I am in Clara's house. I am already in the city. So in Clara's house, I am in a big bed." She just recalled it. She must see the blue sky and feel fresh spring air against her face. So in the village, what happens? Normally, they are in between the greeneries, isn't it? They get fresh air and all those things. But in cities, it's not like that. What happens? Because of buildings, more buildings, you don't get more fresh air. But in village, it's not like that. So she is already used forward to get fresh air from outside. But here she is already in city, isn't it? Wherein she was not getting that fresh air. So that is said here, she must see the blue sky and feel fresh spring air against her face. That air, she has to get the fresh air. And she, when she comes out, because it's a small house, means if she comes out, she can see the sky. But here it's not there, no? Here all apartments and big, big buildings, what happens? You cannot see the sky properly. But in village, it is open air, right? So, the thick curtains drawn across the windows shut those away. So, what happened? She was sleeping in a room where she had the room had windows and the windows were covered with curtains. So what happened? She was not getting the fresh air, plus she was not able to see the sunrise also. The sky, she was not able to see the sky. Because what is covered? The windows were covered with curtains. So it was not permitting her to get the fresh air. At that moment, there came a knock at the door. So when she was just got up from the bed, she was just recalling everything. That time what happened? She could hear the knock at the door. "Breakfast is ready," announced the maid. So who had knocked the door? It was the maid. Who is Miss maid here? Miss Rotemia. Rotemia was the maid here. So what she had done? She just knocked the door of whose room? Heidi's room. Okay. Heidi dressed quickly and went to the... So what did Miss Rotemia say? Rotemia knocked the door and she said, "Breakfast is ready. You please come and have your breakfast." So immediately what happened? Heidi just got up. She brushed everything. She finished. And she came where? Heidi dressed quickly and went to the dining room. Where did she come? She went to the dining room. There, Clara greeted her with a friendly smile. Clara was very happy. Her age, child, no? So your age people, when you get what you feel? You feel very happy and you feel like playing with them, isn't it? The same way this Clara was very happy to see Heidi in the dining room. She was already there in the dining room. So what happened there? Clara greeted her with a friendly smile. She smiled at the Heidi and she greeted, she welcomed her. Come, Heidi, let us have our breakfast. After breakfast, Miss Rotemia told Heidi to go to... the library with Clara and wait for the tutor. So what happened now? Heidi had her breakfast along with Clara. So immediately after they finished their breakfast, who came there? Miss Rotemia came there and she said, "See, you please go to the library room. There your tutor will come and he will be teaching you." See, Miss Rotemia told Heidi to go to the library with Clara and wait for the tutor. So your teacher will come there. Teacher will be taking tuition for you. So you please wait where? In the library room. When the tutor arrived, by the time what happened? The teacher also came. The tutor came. When the tutor arrived, the two girls started studying. So both of them were waiting where? In the library room, waiting for the tutor. So the tutor came. The tutor went to the library room. By the time what happened? Those two children. See who? When the tutor arrived, the two girls, Clara and Heidi, started studying. Miss Rotemia soon heard a violent crash followed by shouts. So they were studying, tutor came, tutor was there. Meantime what happened? This Miss Rotemia was in the kitchen. So suddenly she heard a sound, big sound, and there were shouts. When something falls, it's in ha, it will start, isn't it? The same way, there was a shout in the library. So Miss Rotemia heard that. Okay. See, when the tutor arrived, the two girls started studying. Miss Rotemia soon heard a violent crash. Violent crash means what? Big sound. It was a big sound followed by shouts. And somebody shouted immediately. When something, some sound came, she could hear even the people shouting. She rushed to the library, then stood horrified. So what did Miss Rotemia do? She immediately rushed to, because she heard a big sound, isn't it? So she was very curious to know what happened. So immediately she rushed to the library room. What had happened there? See, Miss Rotemia soon heard a violent crash followed by shouts. She rushed to the library, then stood horrified. When she came to the library, she was just still there. She was just seeing what happened. Okay, she was horrified. She was just seeing what happened there all of a sudden. The table was overturned in the middle of the floor. So what happened to the table? See, The table has to stand. You know what is done? It is overturned. The table has fallen. See, table has fallen. So the table was overturned in the middle of the floor. In the middle of the floor, in that library room, in the middle, the table was placed. It was overturned. A stream of ink trickled slowly across the room. So you can see, even the ink bottle has fallen. And what is happening to the ink? Ink is trickling. It is just, what do you call? Drop by drop, it is falling. So it is trickling. After falling, because it's liquid, you know, it flows. Right? So it started trickling. A stream of ink trickled slowly across the room. Heidi was nowhere to be seen. So when she saw, actually there were three members, isn't it? That was Heidi, Clara and Tootle. But now when she entered the room, only two were there. One was missing. Who was that one? Heidi, right? So she started looking everywhere. Who? Miss Rottenmeier started looking everywhere. But she could not see Heidi. Only these two members were there, Clara and the Tootle. Okay, Heidi was nowhere to be seen. What has happened? Now she is asking, what happened? Cried Miss Rottenmeier. So she started crying. What is this? What happened? Everything is covered with ink. It must be Heidi. Now she said, what happened? So everything is covered with Heidi. That is covered with ink. See, the floor is completely covered with ink. Then it must be Heidi's work, she said now. Because Clara was a very good girl, very soft girl, isn't it? So only the new person who had come to their house was Heidi. And Heidi is also not there. So immediately Miss Rottenmeier understood, oh, this is the work done by Heidi. She said, everything is covered with ink. It must be Heidi. That means Heidi has done this work. The tutor was gazing helplessly at the ruins. The teacher is there. He is helpless looking. But all of a sudden when it happens, nobody can do anything, right? So he was also shocked. And he was just looking at the disturbance what has happened there. Clara, who was secretly enjoying herself, said, yes, it was Heidi, but she didn't mean to. So immediately what Clara did? Clara said, yes, it is done by Heidi, but it was not purposely done. She said, it is done by Heidi only, but it is not purposely done. It has happened by mistake. That is the meaning here. She must not be punished. So you should not punish Heidi. By mistake it has happened, so you should not punish Heidi. Clara is telling to Miss Rottenmeier. Because Rottenmeier was a caretaker of these children. So she is requesting her not to punish Heidi. Yes, it was Heidi, but she did not mean to. She must not be punished. She was in such a hurry to look into the street that she caught the tablecloth and pulled everything down. How it happened? Now she is just narrating that. She is saying that, see, all of a sudden what happened? She wanted to go out into the street. So while going, what happened? She has just pulled the tablecloth. There was a tablecloth on this. So you can see the tablecloth here. On the table, there was a cloth covering. On that, this ink pot and then book, everything was kept. See, books also you can see here. Everything was placed on the table cloth, which was on the table. Understood? So while she was running out to see the street, I was telling her she wants fresh air and all those things. While going out, what has happened? She has pulled the table cloth. So when she pulled the table cloth, along with the table cloth, the table also fell. And not all objects were kept on the table, everything fell down. Understood? So here she is saying, she was in such a hurry to look into the street that she caught the tablecloth and pulled everything down. So that is what she is saying. Who is saying that? Clara is telling to whom? To Miss Rottenmeier. So let us see what is going to happen next. We will see. Miss Rottenmeier found Heidi. Miss Rottenmeier found Heidi standing at the door, looking up and down the street. How dare you run away from your lessons like this? Demanded Miss Rottenmeier. I heard the pine trees rustling, said Heidi. Pine trees? What are you talking about? Come and see the mischief you have done. Never let this happen again, scolded the angry housekeeper. were out of question for the rest of the day. In the afternoon, Clara had to rest for 2 hours. But Hedy wanted to see the pine trees, so she went to a tall tower. She climbed up, but there were only houses to be seen. As she came down, she saw a large grey cat in the basket with 8 furry little kittens. She chose 2 of the kittens and put them in the pockets of her dress. She then hurried home. See, she's very naughty girl. She is very mischievous girl. So what happened? You see, we'll see here now. Miss Rotimia found Hedy standing at the door, looking up and down the street. Okay. So now Miss Rotimia understood now that work was done. The paper was overturned by who? By it was Hedy. So she understood very well. So immediately what she did? She went in search of Hedy. When Miss Rotimia went in search of Hedy, where was Hedy? Hedy was standing outside. See, Miss Rotimia found Hedy standing at the door, looking up and down the street. Understood? So what was she doing? She had come outside. She was standing near the door and she was looking up and down the street. How dare you run away from your lessons like this? Demanded Miss Rotimia. Then what she immediately when she saw Hedy, what did she say? How dare you are? How bold you are to run away from the lessons. The tutor is teaching you. When the teacher is teaching you, how can you run away from them? She questioned Hedy. Demanded Miss Rotimia means she questioned Hedy. She was actually angry. First of all, she has made the floor dirty. Along with that, what she has done, when the teacher is taking class, she has run away from the class. So for all that thought of it, this Miss Rotimia was very angry on Hedy. This is Hedy. Okay, she was very angry on Hedy. I heard the pipe is rustling, said Hedy. So actually what happened when she was sitting there to listen to the lesson, she could hear some sound and she felt that the leaves of the pine tree was just swaying, making that rustling sound. There was a sound made. She just heard that. Okay, when she was just in the library room studying. So she was very much anxious to know, curious to know, what is that sound? So she had come out to the street to see what was that sound. Okay, so that is what she is saying. I heard the pine trees rustling, said Hedy. So she said to Miss Rotimia, now I could hear some sound, so I wanted to find out what was the sound. I have come out. Now Miss Rotimia is asking, pine trees? Because there are no pine trees there. So now she is saying, that girl felt the sound as rustling of pine trees. Now this Miss Rotimia is saying that, pine trees? What are you talking about? What are you talking about? There are no pine trees here. And you are saying that there are pine trees. Come and see the mischief you have done. So now she is saying, come. You just ran away and came now. See what has happened in the library room. Come and see now. She started saying, never let this happen again, scolded the angry housekeeper. She said, this is first and last. Never it should happen again. If you are going to learn, you have to sit and learn. You cannot just run away like this. And never destroy anything in the room. Lessons were out of question for the rest of the day. So what happened? The lesson stopped for that day. Because all this problem started, you know. So the tutor just went away. Could not teach the children because they are of this problem. So tutor went away and their lesson stopped for that. That is, the teaching stopped for that particular day. In the afternoon, Clara had to rest for 2 hours. So afternoon what happened? Normally Clara will sleep for 2 hours in the afternoon. But Hedy wanted to see the pine trees, so she went to a tall tower. Because she had that rustling sound now, so she wants to find out where are these pine trees. So what did she do? She just ran away. She ran away outside to see. Where did she go? To see the pine trees, where did she go? She reached a tall tower. A tall tower was there. She went there. So what she thought? If I stand on the tall tower, I can see the whole city and I can find out where are the pine trees. That was her idea. So she just went to a tall tower to see the pine trees. Meantime, what happened to Clara? Clara wanted to sleep for 2 hours. But this girl, she never slept. She came out and reached a tall tower. She but there were only houses to be seen. So what did she do? She just climbed the tall tower, but she could not see the pine trees. What did she see? She saw only houses. So many houses. Cities means you can understand, no? She saw only houses. As she came down, now she understood there are no pine trees. So slowly what she did? She just got down from that tower. As she came down, she saw a large grey cat in the basket with 8 furry little kittens. So when she came down, what she saw? She could not find the pine trees. She saw only houses. So she got down. When she came down, she saw a large grey cat. There was a grey cat, big cat in the basket. The cat was sitting in the basket with 8 furry little kittens. Means how many children? 8 children are there. 8 children. Children of cat is called kittens. So it had 8 kittens with nice growth of hair. Furry means nice hair was there on their body. So what did she see? She saw a large grey cat in the basket with 8 furry little kittens. So 8 children, 8 kittens also were there along with the mother in a basket. She chose 2 of the kittens and put them in the pockets of her dress. So she had worn a gown, you can see a frock, isn't it? There were big pockets in that. So what did she do? Out of 8 kittens, she picked up 2 kittens. And what did she do? She put those kittens where? In her pocket. See? She chose 2 of the kittens and put them in the pockets of her dress. So she put that kittens in her dress. She then hurried home. So what did she do? She immediately hurried to her house. She wanted to reach the house. So she hurried to the home. So what did Heidi do? She immediately rushed to the house. Now she knew, because she is a newcomer there. So what will Miss Rottenmeier say? She was just worried about it, and immediately what she did, she started hurrying to the house. So let us see what happens in the next class, okay? So let me stop it here. We'll continue in the next class. Thank you.